What's up, what's up, what's up, world? It is Jason Janai, and welcome here back to my channel. It is so good to have you. And in today's video, I want to share with you my DJ furniture kind of story. I want to give you some background as to how I started incorporating these super dope DJ booths into my overall presentation at my private events. I want to give you some insight as to some things I look out for whenever I'm thinking about adding a new piece of furniture into my overall setup. And I also want to share with you a couple of things to think through and even avoid so that you don't make this DJ booth furniture kind of endeavor one that you are going to regret. So if you're looking to take your visual presentation, your DJ setup, your DJ booth to the next level, and you're thinking about getting one of these super cool booths that so many people are using, this video was made for you. Now, using DJ booth furniture, it's nothing new. I mean, we at SCE have been doing it for the past 10 years. And over the past 10 years, I've used a lot of different pieces of furniture to change the visual of how I looked at my events. I've bought things, I've made things, I've created things, I've really experimented with a lot of different things. And quite candidly, I am so surprised that it has taken until 2021 to see so many DJs taking pride in how they look at events and getting on board this DJ furniture kind of booth bandwagon and train. It's something that I can't believe the mobile side and the party side of the DJ world has taken so long to embrace and to incorporate into their setups. I mean, we've been doing it now for 10 years, and I don't think I could ever go back to the way it was in the time before using DJ booth furniture, because it just opens up so many things for you and your company. So you might be asking, why get into a DJ booth? Well, I can tell you firsthand for me, I was all about thinking differently, and I wanted to look different, I wanted to be different, and I really wanted to differentiate myself from a lot of people that were in my local area, all using the same kind of facade setup for their events. I noticed that many people, when going to parties, couldn't really tell who was with which company because everything is unbranded and everything kind of looked the same. So the why it started for me was all about kind of using things that I've seen in my world, whether it be private events that I was able to be part of, or traveling around doing events that I was able to be part of, or even going to places like Las Vegas and looking at how they designed the DJ booth and how it looked in the spaces that were super hot that I loved going to. I remember one of the first times I went to Excess and I saw their DJ booth up on a stage. I was kind of blown away with how it looked, and I thought, man, if I could figure out how to take something like that and bring it to my private events, it would really set myself apart from everyone else. And that was kind of like the inspiration for me. Now, DJ booths in general are a lot of work, but they can do a lot of things for you. They can differentiate how you look, obviously. They can show people how you work and what you're capable of doing if they're watching you. I think DJ booths can help you sell yourself to not just people attending events, but to people that work at venues and in the industry. And I think that the appearance part of this and the presentation part of it is really a big thing. But a lot of people don't realize DJ furniture and using these kind of curated DJ booths allow you to do other things like become more efficient and operate more effectively. And it allows you to be faster if done right. So in my time, I've used a lot of different booths, and I think the major drivers now for how I use furniture is it has to aesthetically, visually fit into the different venues that I work at. It has to fit the types of parties that I do. It has to make sure that my setup and breakdown is efficient and effective, and it is quick. It can't be something that has to kind of be constructed on site. I think that DJ booths as a whole make you look much more professional than when you have multiple cases in multiple places and you're hiding behind a facade and you have a bunch of shit all over the place. When someone walks back there, it looks like a mess, and I don't want to look like that. And I don't think you want to look like it either. I think it's stunning from a guest perspective. If you're using something that looks really nice and is tied together properly, it's impressionable, and your presentation wins in this kind of framework. I think it helps you sell yourself. Now, DJ booths are all over the place now, and there's a lot of different companies popping up and offering them. And my journey started with the company out of Germany called Horrorboard, where Jeff Scott and I ordered the classic Horrorboard booth, and we had it shipped to the United States. We were one of the first customers of Horrorboard in the US, and we were definitely one of the first customers ever anywhere for using those booths at private events. And we established a great working relationship with the team at Horrorboard. We ordered the classic booth that was sent from Germany. We got it through customs, got it to SCE, and right out of the box, we're able to kind of get it working. And man, it helped level up events from that moment forward. From there, we incorporated another booth that Jeff and I went and bought, and that was a Stereo T, which is a very compact, slimline booth that a lot of people to this day still use. I know Nick Spinelli from the SCE Event Group, as well as Christian Lagerteria, they're using them. Jeff Scott still uses his. And those booths are super cool. They're small footprint, they're very, very kind of like condensed look, and they're very simple, they're very streamlined, and it allows you to look very nice from a presentation perspective, and it allows you to kind of get a lot done in a very, very small footprint. From there, I've had a lot of other booths. I've built my own booths, I've done these like column style booths in the past, I've used the Toadmatic booth. I actually had to redesign my own version of the Toadmatic booth based on kind of my needs and the things that we were doing at SCE. And now I have, I think, seven of those booths that I can use independently and interchangeably with each other, which helps me do a lot of different things in a lot of different places when I need to. I've done facade style booths, and we still use facades. I mean, facades are available in different colors and fabrics and kind of materials. And to this day, I think I have four different facade options available for my events and for the people that trust me for their events. But I think really DJ booths as a whole are great ways to take your visual presentation and your service to the next level. They can help you sell yourself, they visually look super dope, they can make you more efficient, and they can basically level up everything at an event because you have something that's a little bit different. So you're able to differentiate yourself. And I think that that wins all the way around. Now, if you're someone that's watching this and you're like, all right, Jason, well, I'm thinking about getting in. I don't really know what to look out for or where to start. What would you give me in terms of advice of what not to do? And that's really what I want to kind of share with you here. I think there's a lot of things to kind of take into consideration when you're building a booth, when you're buying a booth, and if you're looking to incorporate one of these booths into your overall presentation. First and foremost, if you are looking to do this, you need to make sure that you have the ability to work out the operational and logistical details of getting this booth from your warehouse, from your storage, from your garage, from wherever you keep your stuff to a venue and back safely. You have to make sure that you have proper cases or covers made to protect the equipment, because if you don't, these booths will take a beating in and out of events and when you take them on the road. So you have to think about materials, you need to think about weight, you need to think about how you're going to be able to get it into certain, venues. And I often see whenever I post something about DJ booths, there's always someone on Bookface or in a comment that's like, I could never use that, I could never get it in my venue, how much does that weigh, whatever. You have to think about your team, you have to think about how you can use these elements or these pieces of equipment to make your service better, faster, stronger. That's really where it's all about. So if you're working in properties that you can roll right into easily, fantastic. If you have to always go upstairs, you're going to want to take that into consideration before you acquire anything, because some of these booths you just can't take upstairs. It's not gonna happen. I know I have a couple booths that weigh over 400 pounds, and they would be incredibly awkward to try to lift up even two stairs, never mind a flight of stairs. It just wouldn't happen. It would break my back and hurt everyone that was working with me that day. And it's really not something for me to consider. But I have pieces of furniture that can work within those circumstances. So if I have to go up a flight of stairs, or I have to, you know, go a different direction, or I need something that has to transport over a landscape that is not easy to roll over, I've got solutions that I've constructed and built to kind of satisfy my look, my needs, and my events in that instance. So you need to really think about setting up and breaking things down. And I think that if I was gonna build a booth, one of the most important things that I always look at before anything else is this gonna make my life easier or harder? And with each new booth that I incorporate into my overall kind of structure at SCE, my goal is to become more efficient. And I think one thing I always look for is the ability to have all of my stuff internal, ready to go, and plug and play, because I believe that plug and play is where it's at. You unpack something, you take it out of its case, you take its cover off, you plug it into the wall, you run the cables, and you are good to go. And that is something that makes your life better each and every time you use one of these furniture pieces at one of your events. If you have to set things up and screw things in and then put equipment in and cable things off, that is terrible. And although I have one or two pieces of furniture that, you know, I can do that, it's not something that I prefer or I would recommend to anyone. So I would say, if you're looking to get into this, really think through how you are going to be using this booth, and think and make sure that it's something that's going to not hinder what you do and be a drag and a ton of more work, because doing an event successfully is enough work already. Another thing that you always have to think about when incorporating a new piece of furniture into your overall setup is, does it visually tie into the venues that you work at frequently? Does it complement the way the venues look? Will it complement your setup? If you have something that's super modern and you're in something in a location that's super kind of traditional, it might not go. Same with vice versa. If you're using something that's super kind of old school, kind of like vintage or traditional, it might not fit the vibe of a very contemporary venue. So look at the types of locations that you work at all the time and make sure whatever you're thinking about bringing into your kind of service portfolio, make sure it fits the visual aesthetic of the locations that you work at all the time. If it doesn't, keep looking or see if there's something that you can do to kind of twist out that piece of furniture to fit what you need from a visual perspective. Another thing I always think about is, will this DJ booth, outside of visually looking cool, will it allow me to grow, enhance, or boost up my services in any way, shape, or form? Can this booth be personalized or ultra personalized for the events that I'm working at? Is it going to complement everything else that I have working within my company and within the things that I'm doing for the people that are trusting me for their event? If the answer is yes, that's actually big. I mean, like, really big. And if the answer is no, you have to look around and see if there's anything that you can do to maybe switch things up so that you can take your services and the things that this booth allows you to do to the next level. If the answer is still no, then you need to reconsider if this is actually a wise move for you and for your business. The next thing, number four, is all about providing options. And I, to this day, have multiple pieces of furniture that I use at my events. As a matter of fact, I think I have 12 different pieces of furniture that I use with the services I deliver for my couples. And one of the things I like to do is I like to meet with my couples as we get closer to the day, and I allow them the ability to select the booth that visually fits their event best. I allow them to work with me and I will work with them so that we select something that fits perfectly from a visual perspective to complement the overall look of the room and, of course, the vibe of what the couple's looking to do. I think that in a wedding sense, that works. If you think about it from a corporate sense, if you have a booth that has a screen in it, you can skin it, you could logo it, you can incorporate branding, you can incorporate things like jam text or image display, or, you know, if you have a photo booth working, you can incorporate a lot of different elements into these booths to help you take the overall vision to the next level, and that's a big selling point. So if you're thinking about bringing in a piece of furniture and you're not really able to enhance things, it's something that I would raise as a red flag to say, hey, wait, is there anything else that you can do with this? And why are you even considering bringing this in if it's not going to help you in some way, shape, or form? The last thing I think that's super important is the booth going to allow you to differentiate yourself? And if so, how? And can you use that as a selling point to help you, you know, get a little bit further as a business in the future? Booths allow you to differentiate yourself in a lot of different ways. And quite candidly, when placed next to something that is kind of just basic or just whatever, I think booths allow you the ability to really stand apart and stand, you know, in front of a lot of other things. Now, you still have to deliver on the service, you still have to do a lot of other things, but I think having a DJ booth and properly tying it all in, and if you do everything else kind of mentioned in this video, become more efficient and, you know, offer different levels of services or take your offering to the next level, visually tying into the event and incorporating branding or doing this other thing, you set yourself up for a very, 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 very powerful kind of position in the future. Now, I'm going to do a whole series on the DJ booths that I have, and I'm going to kind of go into great detail on how I use them, how I've designed them, and what I like or what I dislike about each and every one of them. So please stay tuned to videos dropping right here on this channel because I'm going to let it all out. I can promise you, you're going to want to see some of these videos. So do me a favor, if you're not yet supporting this channel with some sub love, smash the sub button down below. And if you have a question on anything I've mentioned in this video or in any of the other videos that I have here on this channel, do me a favor, throw it in the comments field, and I promise I will do my best of getting right back to you as soon as I possibly can. I have a ton of content coming out right here on this channel, all about DJ booths, all about taking your events, presentations, your sales, your meetings, your everything to another complete level. And I hope you will jump on board and support the journey because I'm just getting started here. My name is Jason Janai. Hopefully grab some stuff from this video and look out for more content dripping right here really, really soon. Thanks for watching. Peace.